What is PCOS? Is PCOS and PCOD the same? Hello everyone, welcome back. In this video, I'll be telling you all about 5 ways to effectively manage PCOS. Before telling the 5 ways, I would like to tell you all what is PCOD, what are the symptoms, and finally what you can do about it at your home. At the end, you will get one bonus tip. PCOS, that is nothing but polycystic ovarian syndrome, whereas PCOD, that is nothing but polycystic ovarian disease. PCOS is more of a lifestyle disorder. Out of 10 women, every 4 to 5 women has PCOS. Basically, in a human body, we have female hormones as well as male hormones, but in a different ratio. But when it comes to a PCOS person, what actually happens here is the male hormones spike up, and that leads to all the symptoms in a PCOD person. Now the symptoms of PCOS are acne, obesity, male pattern baldness, thinning of hair. We can see irregular menstruation, infertility. Actually, it is the leading cause of infertility in present women. It is a lifestyle disorder. The food we eat, the lifestyle which we have, are all kind of responsible for that syndrome. Yes, this disease, it is more of, instead of disease, you can call it a syndrome. It can be managed. Yes, it can be managed. And you have to be responsible. You have to start taking actions in order to manage your PCOS situation. So I would suggest, just do simple things, even though if you think it doesn't work, because it does work and we fail to see it. Now let's start with our 5 ways to effectively manage your PCOS. First one, the basic one, that is exercise. If you have PCOS, it doesn't mean you are gonna be the overweight person. Even the person with less weight or even normal weight can have PCOS. Whether you are overweight or not, exercise is the key. I would not suggest you all to start gymming. Start basic, start with walking, running, or even simple cycling. These basic things help you a lot. Or start by doing few cardio exercises at home for 3 days a week. That is where you need to start up and pick up. You don't have to go to gym, lift heavy weights and start doing. You just have to start basic and then build on day by day. Second is the diet. First thing, don't eat packaged foods. Eat more of a home-cooked food. Eat of more lower glycemic index foods. Lower glycemic index foods literally means, like for example, if you eat anything and it suddenly increases the glucose level in your body, it means its glucose index is on higher side. So I mean, for you to eat lower index means it takes a lot of time to release the glucose. Such foods. So some of the lower glycemic index foods are as apple, plums, cherries, grapes. Again, one tip is drink green tea. It has lots of antioxidants. Third thing is stress. Now, it is very basic again. Stress is important because your hormones are not in balance and that might really cause stress on you. Some of the ways which you can manage your stress are journaling, and you can go for meditation. Even you can try spending more time in nature and in the things you like, where you feel more relaxed. It doesn't have to be proper classic meditation. If you are not able, like if you are not fond of meditation, you can definitely start journaling. You can spend more time in nature, and what really relaxes your brain. That is personal to everyone. Fourth one is the sleep. Yes, you need to have a balanced, complete, sound sleep. Try to maintain a particular pattern of sleep, such as sleeping at 10 and getting up at 5. If you are not a morning person, you can make it 7 and 11 or 12 depending on you. But make sure you have sound sleep. Fifth one is a particular yoga pose. It is a butterfly pose. So the bonus tip for you is don't eat food from your plastic tiffin box. Switch from plastic to steel. If you find this video helpful, let me know in the comment section. Consider subscribing to my channel for more of medical content and health tips.